Mekhala here from poojas.in. This video is all about my very interesting conversation with a client of mine. You know, every client is a new lesson for me and a new learning, because the kind of questions they come up with, and when we have an interaction, there's so much learning both ways, just not for me or for the client, it's mutual. So this client is from Bombay, and this conversation was all about suggesting remedies to them after having seen the horoscope. So I did suggest remedies which were very simple things, like, you know, every Tuesday go to a Ganesha temple, and every Wednesday visit a Tirupati Balaji temple. So the very next question that I got back from my client was, can I visit any Vishnu temple, why only Tirupati Balaji? So why did I recommend Tirupati Balaji particularly for her horoscope is because Tirupati Balaji has the power of attraction. And Venkateshwara, he's also known as Venkateshwara Govinda, he has the power to attract millions and millions of people to him. So when, you know, in a horoscope, if you see that you lack the power of attraction, which is very much required for your business. So if you lack the power of attraction, which is very, very essential for your overall well-being. For example, if you're surrounded by people who don't like you, then what happens is automatically you get those negative vibes, and you feel very, you feel very suffocated and very horrible to be in such an atmosphere. So what do we recommend is, you always like to, everybody likes to be in company of good people and people who love them and who care for them and things like that, isn't it? So this particular client of mine, I saw that in the horoscope, I mean, she's surrounded by Shatrus. So she's surrounded by people who don't like her, who are always scheming, who are always trying to do something bad. So in that case, you know, she needs to attract good people to her. So that is one reason why I recommended the Tirupati Balaji temple. The another reason why I recommended was because she was in need of money, she was in need of good business opportunities, good clientele. So that, again, that power of attraction is there in Tirupati Balaji temple. We all know the history of the temple. We know even till date how many devotees, lakhs and lakhs of devotees visit the temple, how they are benefited. So I'm not saying go to Tirupati every month, every week, that will, like, you know, you won't be able to do it. Practically, really very difficult. So what I recommended was, if Tirupati Balaji temple or Venkateshwara temple is built in your city, please visit that temple. That is the reason why I mentioned that. So when you don't compromise on your effort towards divinity, the divinity also will not hold back. So that is something that I want you all to understand, that, you know, you don't try to do some, try to see, you know, how much I can squeeze out from divinity by doing very little. You can't do that. Or how much I can do my adjustments and still get the best out of divinity when I do very little. It should be a mutual relationship. Then you can see growth faster, development faster, and you can feel the vibrations. Because through vibrations only you can feel divinity. And that is a very short way of feeling divinity. That's what I want to say. And another reason, another conversation we had was, I had told her to go to a Ganesha temple, any Ganesha temple she can choose. But in that context, she asked me, can I go to a temple where there is Ganesha and there are other deities also? So my answer is that yes, you can. But if the Pradhana Devata, there is Ganesha, you can go there. Why did I say that is because nowadays in a one temple complex, you find so many gods and all are there, but we don't know what is the role they are playing in the temple. For example, if you go to a temple where the Pradhana Devata is Devi and Ganesha is also there, by the way, then you won't get the benefit of what Pariharam or remedy, what I have told you with the intention. The intention is to remove block. So you are highly focused. You are going to the Ganesha temple just for that. See, when you go to any temple, you pray and you seek blessings from the divinity there, whoever it is, whichever form. But when you're going with a purpose, you should go to the right kind of a deity, temple, and you know, where he has the authority. For example, there's a Divinayak temple in Bombay. That is a supreme temple. So you go there, then there are no questions asked. So that is what exactly I'm trying to tell you, that whenever you do a remedy, you be very, very specific with divinity. And you show your intent. It's like this, you know, your mother's name is so and so, your father's name is so and so. And you know, you may meet another person, a stranger, whose name will also tally with the name of your mother. But that person cannot be, that stranger cannot be your mother. Your mother is your mother, that stranger is stranger. You respect that person. you greet that person, you show your warmth, but you cannot, you know, emit the same feelings as you would emit to your mother. So this is just an example I'm trying to tell. Like that, once you consider one form of Ganesha temple in, like for example, Siddhivinayak. So if you say that Siddhivinayak temple is my Ganesha temple where I am going to go and accomplish my goals, then that becomes your father, your mother, everything for that. Then you, even if you go to another Ganesha temple, you bow down, but it's not the same Siddhivinayak. See, here I'm not trying to confuse you all with, you know, even in Ganesha there are so many forms. Ma'am is confusing me with, you know, this, that, then how am I going to do it? It's not like that. It's not for everybody. If you're advised a particular remedy based on your horoscope, the planetary positions, it is with an intention that you're prescribed the remedy. And you please follow whatever has been told so that you can see results. Like, so you visit 7 weeks, 9 weeks, and then you start seeing progress. You see that your blocks are clear. So that with that intention only, I was telling you that, you know, you should not go to one Ganapati temple this week, another Ganapati temple next week, and the third week is a totally different area, different Ganapati temple. Don't do that when you're going with this intention. If you're not going with any specific prayer and you're just casually going because you have that samskar and habit to go and pray, then it's okay. You can go to any temple. You're most welcome. In fact, going to temple itself is a great boon. So even the fact that you enter a temple is a great boon. So you can go to any temple. That's absolutely fine.